Hey everybody, this is John Stauffer. I'm here to bring you a tech tip from Streamingteacher.com. Today I want to talk about how to use a starter hole if you're using a dynamic mill operation. So here's our example. I have a part with two pockets in it, and I have two dynamic mill operations. Both of them have a helix that's coming all the way from the top of the part. You can see they're both just above, so we're helixing in, and that's how we're getting into the part. But if we wanted to start with a pre-drilled hole, you know, because this can remove material very quickly and also helps save on wear on the end of our tool, we need to figure out how to get the tool to go into this hole without having to helix the entire way down and save ourselves some cycle time. So how do we do that? I'm going to go to my other view sheet here for wireframe, and I can see I have a couple circles here. This indicates the position where I'm drilling with a larger drill to get my starter hole started. So for our first pocket, the one, the through pocket over here, this is really simple. All we need to do is go into the geometry and add an air region right at this circle. And this is drawn at diameter for the drill that we're using. Say okay here and say okay here and regenerate that. Mastercam knows that there's no material here, and so it just drops the tool straight in there and then works outward. It won't be centered necessarily, but that's okay. It still has enough room to move out and engage correctly. It's not going to slam into the wall because this does have radial engagement control. Now, this is a little more tricky when we're dealing with a pocket with a floor on it. I can't treat this as an air region because then Mastercam would come down really far, and with a drill, it's going to have a tip on it. So it's not compensating for the material that's left in the drill tip. We have to do this a little bit differently. So for this operation, what we should do is go into our parameters and take a look at our entry motion page. We have a helix radius of 0.225 for a half inch tool. So that's a bit under the radius of the tool, and that prevents having a post in the middle. So we need to keep that number in mind. Go ahead and close this. And then we need to draw in a circle that is at the Z height that we need. So for the particular tool I'm using, it leaves about 155 thousandths for the tip, and we have 10 thousandths on the floor. So let's round up and call that 170. I need to draw a circle at the center point of this circle, a diameter of 225. Then I'm going to move this with dynamic down to the floor of the pocket, and then I'll move my blue ball back to the center for my new reference point and move this up by 170. Say okay. So this we're going to use as our entry chain. We'll go to parameters and switch this from helix only to custom use entry chain. Then select new chain geometry, right click and add, and choose that chain. Say okay. Now in our linking parameters, we can also reduce some of these values, because if we leave them here, we're still going to get the helix all the way up. So go back to parameters and change our top of stock down to the center of this arc. So I'll set it there and say okay. Now our helix is starting a lot lower, and it will come in right where the full diameter of the drill stops. This reduces our cycle time and lets us get away with the least amount of helixing to get into this pocket as possible. Well, thanks for joining us for this video. If you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. But more importantly, if you're looking for high quality Mastercam training, head over to streamingteacher.com.